Hi, welcome. This is Clemens at Elektor. In this video, we will have a look at the serial plotter built into the Arduino IDE. One of the strong points of Arduino is its easy-to-use serial port, which makes it simple to export the data, to send commands to it, or to help with the debugging. Most Arduino users will know about the serial monitor built into the IDE. This is a simple serial terminal that displays any data received on the serial port. It also lets you send strings, for instance commands or data, from the computer to the Arduino port. The serial monitor can be handy for debugging by letting the sketch send text messages about what it is doing or what it is supposed to be doing. The serial monitor can display numerical values too, of course. However, trying to follow the evolution of a parameter when it's printed as a list of values is not always easy, which is why the Arduino IDE also has a serial plotter. The serial plotter creates graphs of the numerical data it receives and displays them. It is not super powerful and does not have many options, but it is easy to use. Unfortunately, there is no documentation for it, and you must refer to the Java source code to find out what it is capable of. Doing so, you will discover the following features: unlimited number of graphs, automatic scaling of the vertical axis, 500 points on the horizontal axis, and it shows the 500 most recent data points. The serial plotter is available from the tools menu, like the serial monitor. After opening it, select the same baud rate as the speed specified in the serial begin in the sketch. The box next to the speed selection box is intended for sending data back to the sketch, exactly as in the serial monitor. This allows you to control the sketch in some way. You don't need to learn the special commands to use the serial plotter. It makes use of the same serial port commands as the serial monitor. The serial plotter is just another way to visualize data sent over the serial port. The only important thing is the way you format the data. To plot a graph of a single parameter, a sensor value for instance, it is enough to delimit the values by a new line character. In other words, use serial print line to send values instead of serial print. The serial plotter uses these values for the vertical axis, the y-axis. It increments the horizontal or x-axis itself. When x reaches 500, the graph starts scrolling horizontally. New points are added at the end and the old points fall off from the beginning. When the Y value is out of bounds, the vertical axis scales up automatically to keep everything within vertical bounds. The same is true the other way around. When suddenly all values fit in a smaller bound, because high values fell off at the beginning when the graph is scrolling, the scale goes down. To draw graphs for two parameters or more, just send the values for the different graphs as a list of values separated by either a comma, a white space, or a tab character, and terminate the list with a new line character. When using the comma as a separator, the format is known as CSV, which stands for comma separated values. Most spreadsheets can import such files, and the better spreadsheet even lets you specify the separator or delimiter character. So when things are looking good in the serial plotter, you can use the serial monitor to export many of these lines and copy-paste them into a spreadsheet to make pretty graphs and do other post-processing tasks. The list of data values is interpreted as Y values for the same X value, so all the graphs update at the same time and same speed. The plotter will choose a different color for each graph. The user has no control over this. The only way to influence this a little is by changing the order of the data. The serial plotter does have one fancy option. It lets you specify a label for each graph. Labels are only available when there are two graphs or more. There are two ways to do this. The first way is to, before sending any data values, first send a list of labels with the labels separated by either a comma, a white space, or a tab character, and end with a new line character. Therefore, the labels themselves cannot contain these characters. The data must be sent in the same order as the labels to match things up. The second way is to send labels and values as pairs and separate the two with a colon character. Make sure to always send these pairs in the same order to prevent the plotter from mixing up the data for different graphs. A list of label value pairs must again be separated by either a comma, a white space, or a tab character, and end with a new line character. Note that as soon as you send a text string, it will be considered a label. It is therefore quite easy to mess up the labels. Another way to mess up the labels is to forget the delimiters, making data end up in a label. The horizontal axis goes on forever. There is no way to restart the graph programmatically. The only way to do this is to close the serial plotter and then open it again. Sometimes it is even necessary to do this twice to get rid of stale labels and or stale data. It is not possible to plot a point at a XY position of your choice. New points are always added at the end. The vertical axis scales automatically, which seems nice, but can be very annoying, especially when there are outliers or glitches that force the scale up and make it hard or even impossible to see the much smaller data of interest. This can also happen when one data series is in the range of, say, minus 1 to plus 1 and another in the range of minus 50 to plus 50. In that case, the scale will be from minus 50 to plus 50. Some people try to outsmart the plotter by adding minimum and maximum values to the list of data values in an attempt to stop autoscaling, but this only works when every value always stays within these bounds. For reasons only known to the developers of the serial plotter, the minimum scale usually is from minus 6 to plus 6. This is a small helper function that I wrote that you can insert in a sketch to make the serial plotter slightly more user-friendly while keeping the sketch readable at the same time. After opening the serial port, call this function like this. If the string label is specified, this function will print a label value pair. If label is an empty string, then it will only print a value. This allows it to output pure CSV formatted data in the serial monitor, good for use with spreadsheets, as we saw before. Note that you cannot have both the serial monitor and the serial plotter open at the same time. Remember to restart the serial plotter by closing and reopening it every time you modify the sketch to ensure that all stale data and labels are removed. When in doubt, do it again. So, we have now come to the end of this video. Summarizing, in this video I explained how to use the serial plotter integrated in the Arduino IDE. And we saw that it's not too difficult to use as long as you stick to the formatting rules. The formatting rules are separate the data by either a comma, a white space or a tab character, and end with a new line character. We also saw that it is possible to add labels to the graph so that they are easier to identify. All in all, even though it is a bit limited, the serial plotter is a nice tool to have. Okay, that's it. I hope you found it interesting. Please don't forget to subscribe to our channel and click or tap the bell button. Thank you for watching.